weeping, my God, why have you abandoned me? Let us pray. Our Father and God, who have read from the scripture today, and at this point it is excruciating pain in that truth, the torture and the weight of our sin upon you, Father, be submitted yourself to Christ. Lord, in our lives, we see things that seem to you very today. Because after now, O Father, these things are continuously exercised in our lives as seem to be, and the mind of you. I want to start this commentary with sharing an experience and a story that has to do with my experience sometime many years back. In the course of my duty, I have witnessed and supervised an intervention. So most of you, when people talk about crucifixion and somebody being executed, you read it from the scriptures and probably watch the film. Sometimes in my career, some years back, during the murder of the Ogoni Nine, I personally standing before you for five that execution. And since anything I remember that experience, I begin to imagine what Christ himself has through. On that day, yesterday, I was coming to work. And before I could get to office, there was an unusual presence of the ministry around the place. Fans were rolled out, some of the personnel carrying vessels were running. I started wondering what it was that the soldiers had taken over my mind. After about 20 minutes, I saw a long convoy of military vessels bringing these nice people for execution. And when they came, 2 days after, some people came to travel together where the execution was expected. Before I went in there, the handsman was already around. The sheriff was there, the medical doctor was there, who would pacify the day in the case of everything. There, they handed over to me the medical warrant of my table. An experience I really want to share with you. I sat here that day that I would watch people go into the other and be home in my presence. That it was called to visit, I had to do it. So when they came in their hands, they had nothing but the Bible. Hallelujah. In their hands, they had nothing. They had only a professor, well recognized. But what book they held in their hands was the Bible. That teaches you that every other book is subjected to the book of God. And so when I was given the mandate to march safely to where they were executed, I said, your blood is not upon me. I have acted on instruction. I moved them to the small house where there is a narrow path to the gallery. And I was asked to cover their faces with a roof. And the gallery is such when you stand on it, the liver will give way. And the person pulls down without God's blessing. After that experience, I went home and thought about if a man would be so executed, what of Christ that was in Christ? The subject of every form of trial was that of Christ in the history of any trial. The man that was arrested, 2 days after he was sentenced, there was no criteria for him to appear, and was laid to the point of the crucifixion. I wanted to arouse the witness for you to have in view what Christ passed through on this day, especially when you have to cry out to the Lord, my Father, why have you forsaken me? Of course, you have to cry out because the full weight of the sin of the world was already upon him. The body was not. The excruciating pain was not there. The body of present day had down on him at that point in time. And what else he could do? He couldn't call to any man. He could call to his Father. But unfortunately, that time, his Father had allowed him to take the full weight of his body. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have to say now, the man was frustrated to get his trust with him. A kind of test and mockery that was louder and nothing against him. A man that came to save his life and we did allow him to leave. We have seen one another that he came to die as a substitute for us. The father came. The men carried a claw of him. The flesh upon his head to ask the king of Jesus. And of course, to make his conscience of no value, they have to find him to drink life because of your life. What the task of the body passed through because of our redemption. And this was the same God who went on a power to include. They have used him, they caught him. You were able to say, you confess it was God's will for you to say that you destroyed the temple. And at the same day, you revealed it. And this is the temple is so value in their history. And so they went down within you with the cross. He said, you said, Father, this is the time to take your love. And criminals come within you. All shall be available about our Lord. Just as we are having a day like this, Good Friday is always the day of passion. As we are marching in, there were no noise. There was no song. That is an indication that today is historic in the life of Christendom. My brothers and my sisters, that same Christ sees us in today. That Christ did not see on the cross. Our continuous measure in sinful life has always challenged Christ to be trying daily, asking us to come round to him and repent us, because he remembered the way to salvation. I want to also say that he died so that all nations shall be free. He has the greatest proposition on the path of the Jews. Who denied him and who said he was blaspheming? The mockery on him was unspeakable and his suffering unbearable. Like I know in the place I walk. 2 days ago, I had to sign up an inmate who was sentenced to death. He was not going to court that day. But when he came back, his devotions were not taken. So God, they have condemned me. This is human condemnation. How will the condemnation of God be met? It's going to be terrible and unbearable than that. The day of his death, you may not know. It is the day of death. But our Christ is not committing his sin. He never lost, he never did not. And before he knew it, they had arrested him. They had protected him to unspeakable conduct and terror. And because of you and I, he committed to die. And on the cross, the weight of the sin of the world became so much that it needed his father to come in his presence. And that's why he had to cry, my father, why have you protected me? Let God not forget us in the mighty name of Jesus. Not make life cry again. It is all about the renewal of our life. So that anywhere we go, Christ laughs instead of crying for you. I have a little analogy to make, and that is to say that every day there is mounting rise of sinfulness. Even the those that profess that Christ is also their God, the language and the word of sin seems to overtake and overrun us. But there is a sign Christ has cried, and is crying for you today, that the letter of the word sin that is spelled by S-I-N, a Christ has come. So the letter I in sin can be changed to letter now. The letter I in sin can be changed to letter O. So that from sin you become the son of the Most High God. Hallelujah. Amen. By this dying on the cross, that sin, God was able to modify them. And I pray in all sincerity that every day you live your life, come the letter I in sin, to the letter O in it. And instead of being a sinner, you will become the son of the Most High God. Shall be done in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us pray. God our Father, the Redeemer of the world, the man who died as a substitute for me. For the Bible says, when we are far off, Christ died for us. He made us in his love and brought us home. Father, your children have come to commemorate your passion and death. Let every simple life be alive. Let every blessed beginning in the end die today in the mighty name of Jesus. Let us be the first time of God, so that this time we have to cry and talk about our sins. Father, you will cry again in our life. This is our prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord.